Hey guys, it's Brenda from Gumdrops and Lollipop Tarot bringing Libras their monthly love read. Monthly Libra. I'm doing December 2022. I can't believe 2022 is almost over. We are going to do you, them, and the connection today, and then of course get some oracle cards. Ooh, and message cards. Three cards just came out to describe you, Libras. Oracle cards and message cards, and then we're going to finish off the read with a fairy tale oracle. Which I'm not sure what I think about the fairy tale oracle guidebook for love reads right now, but that's okay. These are general reads, so please take what resonates, leave the rest. If you feel like this is really not your read at all, go ahead and check your moon and your rising signs. If you're unclear as to what your moon and your rising signs are, there is a link in the description box below to get you that information. There's also a link in the description box below to get you to my personal webpage if you're interested. I think that's it. Thanks for watching, guys. Oh, Libras, I want to give you a big giant hug. We're showing up. The overall energy is loss, sadness, grief, heartbreak. And then under that's the Queen of Wands with the Wheel of Fortune. So I feel like things will be moving out of this heartbreak and sadness, but this is the energy of the overall read at the moment. So grief, loss, heartbreak, sadness. So let's get into it, guys. So Libras, I feel like you have been struggling with a situation in which you are not being truly honest with yourself. This moon card here is showing like secrets and lies coming to light. I feel like you've been trying to hide something and not be honest with yourself about a situation. But you're self-sabotaging yourself. This might be where your sadness and heartbreak and loss is coming from. Your reality of what you think is happening is not what's happening. You're seeing everything very negatively. If you look in this picture, this girl is looking into a mirror. She is not bound. She is not blindfolded. But the picture, the reflection in the mirror is. So she's like self-sabotaging and thinking a situation is worse than it really is. I feel like you're telling yourself lies. There's illusions and lies and you're not really being honest with yourself. But you're showing up in this connection as a wish fulfillment, someone who is full of hope. So I feel like, and in the connection we have moving on to calmer waters. So I feel like you will be making this shift. To be hopeful, to be happy, to be someone's wish fulfillment, to be fulfilling your wishes as well. Your person is showing up a little conflicted too with this Two of Swords energy. They too are blinded. They too are not sure what to do, which path to pick, which way to move, how to move forward, how to proceed. However, they will be coming towards you. We have the Page and the Knight of Pentacles. I feel like they'll be coming with some good news, but these are very, very slow energies. The Pentacles, the Knight of Pentacles is the slowest knight in the deck. Slow and steady wins a race, but this is very grounded, loyal, committed energy. This is long-term. This is stable. So this person's showing up stable, but they are just needing to figure out what the heck to do, which path to pick, what road to take. The road is going to be towards you guys. I feel like this connection is moving on to calmer waters. So, you know, they might be indecisive. You might be telling yourself lies, but you guys are going to move on to a much smoother situation together. I do think it's going to be grounded, stable, loyal, committed, long-term, emotionally stable, financially stable, and fiery, sexy, passionate energy is also here. So I feel like as indecisive... Oh my God. Pardon me. As indecisive and in your head as you are, and as indecisive and in their head as they are, it's still going to turn out well. You guys are going to move towards something calmer. I feel like together, I think you're going to move away from whatever's causing you this stress and anxiety and sadness and get this happiness and this groundedness and this fiery, passionate energy. Oofed. I am so sleepy. I'm so sorry. We're going to get the, I'm contemplating stopping after you and just finishing these tomorrow, but we're going to get the Love and Romance Journey deck from Queen Sugar Tarot for Libras. Journey. You're clearly on a journey. Regret. Yep. Abandonment. Stop. Magnetic connection. Yeah, so I feel like you're definitely on this journey, right? I think this regret and abandonment that you felt in the past is something that you're dealing with, and you're just gonna have to just kind of let that go, let that be, and stop. I think that this is a magnetic connection between you and your person. It is romance and true love, but I think you're getting through this hard part of your journey. You could potentially be going through the dark night of the soul with these feelings of regret and abandonment. But I feel like you're gonna set boundaries and you're gonna stop yourself from being stuck in that negative energy, in that Eight of Swords energy. This is very magnetic connection, very much a magnetic connection between you and your person. With that King of Wands, it's like super intense. All right, let's get some soul reflection, the Soul Reflections Love Oracle cards for Libra and their person. The gate is open. Take a leap of faith and walk through. First kiss. Illusions. What's fantasy or reality? Retreat. Take time to walk away to find yourself. I feel like you're going, getting through those illusions. That's that moon card that's showing up in your energy, Libra. You're figuring out what's real and what's not. You are taking a step away to heal, finding yourself. But you guys, you're gonna have this great magnetic connection with someone. This gate is open. It's gonna be a time to move forward, walk through that gate, take that leap of faith and love. There'll be a first kiss if there hasn't already been one. We're gonna look at heart-to-heart messages from Crystal Moon Oracles. The telepathy between, there is telepathy between our hearts. I can feel your energy all around me. You will hear from me soon. Yeah. I think that's that Page of Pentacles energy, the good news. I think it'll be a small message, but they'll be coming. Love Vibe Oracle deck from King of Aloha. Let's just be friends, platonic. I think that's you stating that. I think that's part of your lies and deceptions and self-sabotage. You're not my usual type, but I'm still attracted to you. I don't think we feel the same about this. So these two cards here, I feel like is really you being in your own way, you self-sabotaging the situation. This is where you start coming out like, well, you're not my usual type, but I am attracted to you. So you will kind of move out of that self-sabotaging energy. All right, we're gonna get some White Rose Guidance Divine Love messages. This is gonna be a short read, Libra, sorry. I'm like, did I forget a deck? I did not. Your face haunts me day and night. You are my everything. You are my muse. Well, that reminds me of you're my downfall, you're my muse, my worst attraction, my rhythm and blues. All of Me from John Legend. All right, guys, we're gonna finish off your read with the Fairy Tale Oracle. These have been like more as like personal information or things to know, not necessarily reflective of a love read, but we'll see what pops out for you, Libras. We got the Wild Swans dedication, number 42. This also has like a whole story of the fairy on the card. I'm not reading the whole entire passage. It would take me forever, and I read like I'm just learning how to read when I'm on video. So I'm just going to read the part where it talks about the message, okay? This is a tale of suffering in order to save family or people we care for from a fate that is not their choosing. It is a tale of sacrifice and of sacrifice that must be done without recognition for a long time. In this tale, a young woman's brothers are enchanted into the form of swans, and she is told that there is only one way to make them free. And that is through the spinning of magical cloaks made from the flax of stinging nettles. Not a word can be spoken during this task. So for years, the young woman has hands that are disfigured from the burning and the pain, and feet that can barely tread upon the earth, and she must do all of this in silence. Her dedication to this bizarre task And of her silence in the face of demands for explanations creates mistrust all around her. But the truth is she cannot speak. She must keep to her task, and for she has dedicated herself to saving her brothers. This is the madness of doctors, scientists, and those who discover ways of healing and helping that seem bizarre and strange, incomprehensible to others. So this is the message of this card, to know that when we see people who are ferociously dedicated to a task or a mission, their single-mindedness may seem like madness, and in some ways it is. But if this energy is put to great purpose, it can bring about great healing and change. This message could be that you must allow this and not judge this. And this message could also be that your own dedication may be perceived as madness and even create hostility within the hearts of others. But it will result in healing, creativity, and great breakthroughs, just as Alyssa's work, painful and bizarre as it seemed, saved her brothers from the enchantment. The meaning of this card is tenacity and dedication works magic, working through pain to create results, single-minded passion, misunderstood dedication, silently working without explanation for a time, and working without the approval of others. Yeah, this I almost want to stop reading from this book, but I feel like it would be unfair to not give everybody else a message. All right, thank you so much, guys, for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already. I'm so close to 550 subscribers. I appreciate it so much. Thank you, and take care, guys. Thanks for watching.